Welcome, Knights of Apollo. It's Pixelated Apollo, and we are back at Kaer Andros. This, of course, is Third Age Total War. We got a nice 1v1 siege battle, and it may be a 1v1, but this is a pretty large battle because the unit scaling is on huge. So we got some very large armies. It's a fight between the dwarves and Rune. So I guess Rune conquered Kaer Andros from Gondor, and the dwarves, they've marched an army over to take it back. So let's get started with the army comps and the player names. We'll begin with the dwarves, commanded by Sultan Thorn. He is bringing a good mix of iron crossbowmen. He has a lot of great heavy infantry, which is no surprise because he's the dwarves. So he's bringing some iron guard. This is going to be the first wave in the assault. You know, they're taking the tower or the ladders here to the walls. And then the second line here, we have some Axemen of Erebor. He's bringing some Dragon Slayers, lots and lots of Dragon Slayers. Guards of Khazad-dûm. And in the back, he has some Volt Wardens. So a pretty solid force, a pretty nasty force. And it's going to be really challenging for Rune. But hopefully Rune can use his terrain advantage to try to destroy the dwarves. We've seen me fight on this battle against dwarves. And if you have a lot of archers up here and you just hold with your infantry, you can just pepper down those dwarves. They're a slower army, but... you know, you just gotta watch out for that heavy infantry. Anyways, Rune is commanded by Eva. He is bringing some clan crossbowmen. He's got some clan guard who are helping protect them on the walls. And then at the gate, he has the Luke Gamperim, the halberd or polearm unit. He's got some reserves in the back. He's got the Luke Flagrim, the very elite Easterlings. And then way over here, holding this defense, we've got some Javis, clan crossbowmen, the dismounted Varigs, and he has some more Flagrim and the elite archers. So two units of Luke Narrim. So that's his army. You know, compared to the dwarves, it's kind of small. So we'll see what he does here. I think hold the phone. He's got a bunch of troops out here. Okay, wow, okay, that changes things. He's got a small, like, attacking force. This is beautiful. I had no idea he had this force. So they're going to be attacking the flank. The really cool position. He also has some cav over here. I really like the aggressive defense. You know, this small, like, attacking force in his defense. This is great. But he is charging in some cav. What are they doing? Why did they stop right there? What? No, is he not paying attention? Oh my goodness. That was a wasted charge. Three of his men died there because he was not paying attention. I guess he was focusing elsewhere. But he's got some clan guard charging down to try to contain the dwarves before they reach the archers. The archers are going to continue to fire, and hopefully he can get a good charge here. He needs to go after expensive units like the Dragon Slayers, go after the crossbows. If he can take out a bunch of those crossbows, then his archers are going to be sitting pretty. Like, he's going to have no answer to the defending archers. So I think it's kind of a waste to go after the Iron Guard. All these crossbows are open for an attack, for a charge. So I think he needs to charge down there, take care of them. The dwarves are now scaling the walls. Man, there's a lot of things going on. I'm trying to talk at 1,000 miles per hour. We might do some slow motion here and there, but here they come. The dwarves. Oh, that poor guy died, and we heard it too. Ah. Watch out for arrows, you know? You never know when they're going to hit you. But we got a pretty epic brawl on the walls. Let's see how long the clan guard can hold against the iron guard. It's the battle of guards. And then we've got more troops attacking on the outer gates here. This is a beautiful battle. It's a beautiful day, too, in Middle-earth. This is definitely going to slow down their assault. Let's see how the archers are doing. Oh, there we go. That's what I'm talking about. He charged into the crossbows. We do have the Axemen of Erebor trying to protect him, though, which is a good decision. He should probably move up his Volt Wardens. Oh, man, this army is massive. It's just a massive force. I love it. I wish we would see more people defend with their troops outside the walls like this. Now, this settlement is really cool. because it gives you a lot of space to deploy your army outside of the walls. So, like, you can deploy your army all in these hills over here. So that will give you, like, a really good defensive position. Because most of the time, like, in standard Medieval 2, you can only deploy inside the walls. Which I think is pretty bullcrap because, you know, I mean, a defender would have, you know, units for ready for ambush outside of the walls. Good. We got a really, really epic brawl here. But the gate is open. The Axemen are about to charge in. The Luke Gamprim, they're going to wait patiently for them to embrace the Axemen of Erebor. And, oh, jeez. What in the world? Okay, the Iron Guard just slaughtered the clan guard. I was about to say clansmen. I don't think that's a correct term for that unit. I guess we'll head back over here. This is where most of the action is. The dwarves are kind of attacking in waves, which is a little questionable. I think he wants to take care of this army outside first, potentially. I'm pretty sure his Iron Guard are going to lose in this fight. I mean, they're just so outnumbered, and they're taking on some pretty elite units. See the archer's point of view. Oh, did the archers use up their ammo? They're attacking some dwarves. Yeah, you gotta make sure you use up that ammo. And the dwarves are actually flanking around with their axemen. Oh, there we go. They're firing again. Yeah, they definitely need to pepper down these axemen. You don't want your troops outflanked. You gotta protect your flanks or your infantry will break very quickly. They will crumble. I think it's only a matter of time, though. Oh, God. Oh, no. Jeez. The dwarves just sneaking down this little opening here. This leaves a big opening for the catapult. Rune, get your troops out of... There he goes. I'm just glad he's moving his troops. Most of the time, people will just leave their troops in the fight, even though they're getting murdered by a catapult. Ooh, he got really lucky there. He could have lost a lot more men over there. And then over at this little hill... We got a nice fight. A small unit of dwarves. I don't think they have enough to break through. But the Iron Guard, they definitely made some progress at taking out this defense. Now we have the Dragon Slayers moving up. The Axemen still waiting patiently. Waiting to charge. God, the Iron Guard. They don't break easily. They do not break easily. They're down to 41. But they're taking on a much larger unit, a couple units. Here comes the Dragon Slayers to support their Iron Guard. They will not leave their dwarven brothers in a time of need. And we have some crossbows going around the flank. So we might see some crossbows take on the archers. The archers, oh, this is actually really good. You see what he did here? His archers are behind the hill. Because he has a composite bow. So he can fire more of a rainbow shot, if you know what I mean. You ever play basketball and you call it a rainbow shot? Anyways, I don't know what I'm talking. I'm rambling on over here. But they have a much better shot compared to the crossbows, who fire more straight, direct towards an enemy. So let's see. Are they going to fight or are they just going to shoot at each other? I don't know. They're like sharing the same hill. Oh yeah, this is a skirmish battle right here. This is weird. Oh, man. This is cool, though. The Axemen still hanging on. They're still attacking on the flank. I think it's only a matter of time until these guys break. But they are taking out a lot of dwarves. Now, the question is, was this a good idea? Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. More catapult stuff going on over here. Did he charge out his pole arms? I guess so. I guess he's trying to silence that catapult, but he is retreating back in here. Man, these Iron Guard, they're so good. They're so good. The Axemen are now pouring through the gate. Mon, you are the brave men of Rune. whenever your troops need uplifting, just say you're the brave men of wherever they're from. So if they're from France, you're the brave men from France. England, you're the brave men from England. That just instantly inspires them to keep fighting. Trust me, I know. I'm a really just a master commander. Not really. Don't listen to me. So the question now is, when should he retreat? Like, when is enough is enough? Like, when is he gonna fall back and hold this choke point here? Now the good news is that he's holding fire. I was really concerned that he would waste his ammo, but he's doing a good job of being very patient and waiting for the perfect time to strike. So I think Rune is doing a pretty good job overall. Even though I probably wouldn't charge out troops like this in the outer walls, it was really cool to watch, and he got a decent amount of kills from it. So it wasn't a complete fail. And we got the Iron Crossbowmen fighting the dismounted Varigs in melee. Uh-oh, guys. Look at this guy, he's freaking out. He's like, no, take me as a prisoner, don't kill me. The good old glitches in Third Age Total War. Alright, so the dwarves are moving up their iron crossbow up this hill. This hill is just death. You never want to give up this hill. I mean, that's probably why the reason Rune sent out his forces to try to defend it. I think if he was a little bit more defensive with his forces outside here, he would have lasted a little bit longer. But now the Axemen are going to take this hill and then fire down. Oh, jeez. Oh, the clan crossbowmen. Oh, they're doing their best to try to defend this settlement, but they are getting harassed, and soon they're going to get shot at from the dwarves up from that hill. Here's another charge from the swordsmen, or the Lukeflagrim, who actually have maces. Oh, take cover. Very good move there. Take out these axemen. Take them out. All right, so we got more reserves back here. He needs to stop sending more troops down that way. He needs to keep whatever men he has left to hold. You don't want to commit all of your infantry because you have nothing to protect the choke point back there. Now we've got some guards of Khazad-dûm coming in. Oh, that catapult, it's winding up. It's ready to get some kills. Oh, this is why it's so hard to hold a gate like this. Let's see if he can get some good hits here. Oh, hold on to your butts. Oh, jeez. Okay, so he's safe there. That is good. Now the Vault Wardens are moving forward. Most of the infantry has been committed from the dwarves. The fighting is still going on outside here. So very brave stand from the halberd unit. But they are breaking. They're down to 20. It's just too much. I can't blame them for that. And the crossbows are up here firing down at their position. Yep, and the crossbows are going to be firing at the men over here. In case you didn't know, the building here, you can shoot through it. It's not really an actual building. It just kind of is cosmetic. Oh, he's firing at the wall. Yep, he's firing at the men on the walls. Really good flanking maneuver with the crossbows. Being very observant about the terrain on the battlefield, that is very important to win a lot of battles. And we've got some pretty intense fighting here. It looks like it's a lot more close quarters. The two front lines have really grouped up together. And the Dragon Slayer is pouring down from the wall. He's got some Dragon Slayers coming around this way too. That is so cool that you can actually flank around like that from the walls and get on the grass here. But we got some tribesmen holding back Dragon Slayers. That is not a good matchup. They are not going to win that matchup. And now is the time where he needs to call the retreat. Because he doesn't have any infantry. He has zero infantry. All these guys are just archers. So he needs something. Like right here, you see where my mouse is? Just a couple units of infantry to hold back the dwarves. And let the arrows just release into the dwarven horde. Okay, I think he's... Alright, he's finally using his ammo. Yep, look at that. All the arrows pouring down. Oh, geez. He's gonna get a decent amount of kills. That's why he just needs to fall back. I mean, that's gonna really help him in this fight. But he is getting a lot of friendly fire. And his men are really dying pretty quickly against the guards of Khazad-dûm. Does he have any infantry left? Like, this is it, really? Oh, come on, man. You gotta keep some in reserve. You can't just send them all in. Even just one unit would be helpful. Oh, he's sending in his crossbows into melee now. God, he's getting a lot of friendly fire. He needs to get his troops out of there. He's losing so many from his own arrows. You can just see him get hit in the back. I mean, yes, he's getting a lot of kills, but is it worth it? I mean, it is the guards of Khazad-dûm. Very important target. Dragon Slayers are victorious over here. Oh, now he's setting up his catapult on this hill. Jeez, it just never ends. And the crossbows are firing at... I think they're firing at the clan crossbows over on this side. I'm not really sure if his crossbows can reach this side. But the clan crossbows trying to take out these Dragon Slayers, which is really important. Gotta try to take out this flank over here. Because, yeah, they're going to flank around, and they're going to try to outflank the men who are guarding the gate. And now we got the crossbows, iron crossbows joining the fight. Oh, and then crossbowmen are going to try to slow down these Dragon Slayers. Oh, jeez. That's not good. Oh, that catapult is going to be absolutely brutal on this defense. He needs to space out his men. They are really really grouped up there. It's an easy target for the catapult. But now we have a lot of dwarves in one area. This is now a good opportunity to really release those arrows into this position. Oh my god, that catapult's getting so close. Here comes the next volley. Hold on. Direct hit in a very expensive unit. Why is he not spacing them out? That's what you got to do against that catapult. You want to save those men. And now his men defending the gate are surrounded. The balance of power is in favor of the dwarves, but it's far from over because the dwarves are going to have to take out that hill. Oh, and they killed the general! Oh my god. Why would he leave his general in sight of the catapult? He needs to put his general, like, over here. That's a tough one to see, guys. That is an absolute tough one to see. But again, even though the general is dead, it's a siege battle, and they have infinite morale in the town center, so they don't necessarily need a general. But it kind of sucks to see him die like that. Oh, he needs to use his cav to charge down this unit over here. I mean, you might as well use the general's bodyguard. Come on, charge him down. Charge him down. Ah, geez. See, it could be way worse, though, if they were not in loose formation. Is he going to charge down his general? No. He's going to let the Dragon Slayers just run up there and kill his men. He should be focusing all firepower on the Dragon Slayers right here. There he goes. Come on. Don't worry about that catapult. Pretty soon he'll run out of ammo. Fire. Oh, they're walking into battle now. Very tired. Yeah, so now he's going to use his crossbows as a melee unit. That was a great opportunity to charge his cav in there, but he just did not take it. The defenses have been slaughtered, and now the dwarves are setting up their army. We've got some clan crossbowmen who are breaking, so they're pretty much useless. And we got more archers just charging into melee, and this is the final attack. He's going to use his dismounted Varigs, which is an okay infantry unit, like a versatile archer unit. But they are going to have a very tough time against the elite dwarves over here. Come on, arrows. Keep on taking out those dwarves. He's got his javies over here, too. They're going to be pretty useful. Oh! Oh, man, that catapult's getting really close. Keep on putting down the fire. Oh, there we go. He's finally moving out his cav. I think he's going to try to... What? He's just charging them into the fight. He should have just, like... Try to get around them and then flank. Get some charges in. The dwarves are losing. They are losing. The iron crossbows are now in melee. This... He could turn this around, but... Oh, jeez. Well, look what's left of the dwarves, the guards of Khazad-dûm. He's got like two more units of them, and he's got the Vault Wardens. But, you know, he still has a ton of archers. Tons and tons of archers. That catapult, though, it's getting like three kills every shot. I don't know. I don't think he has enough. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Hammer in anvil. Good use of the cav, and it's breaking the dwarves just like that. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful use of the cav. I should have used it a little bit earlier, but that's okay. At least he's using it now, and he can now focus his attention on the guards of Khazad-dûm that are running up this way. I think this is it for the dwarves. The balance of power is slowly shifting back in Rune's favor. He can do this. He can. He can do this, I believe. I think he's going to send forward some crossbows to try to slow down this unit so he can continue to fire at it. Oh, get your cav out of there. Don't leave him stuck in melee against the guards of Khazad-dûm. Ooh, the javies are throwing in their javelins. Get that cav out of there. I guess he's just going to leave the cav. I mean, they're pretty much useless now, I get. I mean, even with three cav troops, you can get some good charges in. Just as long as he has archers up on this hill firing, he can still win this. He's trying to take out... Oh, come on. Come on, he's using the tribesmen. Defeat seems certain for the guards of Khazad-dûm. They can do this. Yes, the defenders can do this, guys. This is a really good battle. It's going to come down to the wire. Just as long as there isn't a chain route from Rune, he can beat the dwarves because of his skirmishers. Vault Wardens down to 24 men. God, they got ripped apart from the... Oh, now he's using fire arrows. He's trying to break them. That is a good idea right there because they're so depleted. The balance of forces are now evenly matched. The guards of Khazad-dûm are not messing around. I thought he had another Vault Warden unit. Oh, yes, they are over here. Oh, and he still has some Dwarven Noblemen. And he has a catapult crew that's going to be running over. Jeez, I did not expect this to be so close. Not at all. I thought the Dwarves are going to just trash Rune. Oh, geez. The Vault Wardens are breaking. We got some clan crossbowmen trying to attack the flank. I think it's a pretty good idea that the dwarves... See, this is a situation where attacking in waves is not a terrible idea. Because if he sent forward all of his army at once, then the archers would have just obliterated them. So, let's see if this tactic's going to work for the dwarves. I mean, he's got, let's see, more iron crossbowmen. Or no, that's the catapult crew. Vault Wardens. More iron crossbowmen. I mean, he's running low. And I think Rune's running low on ammo. It might be why he's using fire arrows too. Because he's, you know, it's slower rate of fire. Who knows? But we got some troops pushing down the hill. Rune's going to try to, you know, expose some flanks around the dwarves. Look at this lone horseman here. He's been fighting like this whole time. Let's watch how long he lasts. Come on, man. Kill some guards of Khazad-dûm. It says victory is almost a certainty now. That's insane. They're down to 41 men. They really haven't lost that many. Oh, he died. Rip in peace. Yeah, I'm sure he's running low on ammo. He's running very low on ammo. And the dwarves are running low on troops. I like the fact that he's trying to block the reinforcements from helping the guards of Khazad-dûm. Victory seems certain for Rune. But the general, he's coming over. He's a coming. The javelin men are now fighting in melee. But he's got this big gap right here that the dwarves are going to try to use against Rune's defense. Oh, and the guards of Khazad-dûm doing everything they can to try to silence the archers. Defeat is now... No. Victory is a distinct possibility. Still, they're down to 32 men. Here comes the general. Desperate times. Desperate times. Vault Wardens, they're very healthy. They're still 59 men. They are getting shot with some arrows, though, so who knows how long they're going to last in this fight. And it's getting so close to the end, guys. So close. See, on one side, we have a ton of lower tier, like archers and javies. And on the other side, we have a bunch of dwarves. Or not a bunch, actually a small amount of dwarves, but they're very elite. Elite versus, well, quantity versus quality, essentially. But if he can destroy the Vault Wardens, which it doesn't look like he's going to, in fact, I think he should just retreat this unit and get them behind the general. And just let the Vault Wardens march forward, and then you just focus your ammo on the Vault Wardens. I think the dwarves got this, guys. I think it's safe to say. There's no way they're going to stop the dwarven noblemen and the guards of Khazad-dûm. Oh, wait, are they breaking? No, they're exhausted, though. They're falling back a little bit. We are down to the last couple minutes of the battle. The Vault Wardens going strong. Victory seems certain. The catapult crew is getting chewed up, though. That's okay. That's what they're made. That's what they're there for. And all of Rune is now engaged in melee. He no longer has any archers. The dwarven general is behind enemy lines, just kind of checking out the battlefield. He's like, huh. I'm behind these Easterlings here, but I don't feel like attacking them. I'm just gonna... Oh, there he goes. There he goes. Who is he attacking? Who? This might be why the dwarves are really struggling here. What is going on? He's attacking the air. Well, I mean, Rune's doing pretty good over on this flank. Jeez. These dwarven noblemen, they're just so good. Oh, he's going to try to stop the flank here. Try to slow him down. Who will win? Who will die? Yeah, the balance of power is now shifting in the dwarves' favor. There's always an epic brawl on this hillside whenever you play this settlement. I do love this settlement a lot. Yeah, with the Vault Wardens marching forward, I think that's it, guys. There's no way. If the Vault Wardens weren't here, then I think it would be a little bit closer. But look at that balance of power. This one's over. It's over. That's game. Rune almost beat the Dwarves. It was really, really close. I think he made a couple mistakes at the beginning. I did like the fact that he charged out some troops at the beginning of the fight. But I think he should have left one or two infantry units in reserve. That way he could have continued to fire his ammo at the Dwarven lines for a very long time without having to sacrifice any archers and going into melee. But still, nonetheless, great battle from both players. Fantastic replay. I definitely love these close fights. The general, who knows, like maybe they'll kill the general and then the Dwarven army will break. I doubt it, but you never know. Oh, yeah, get some Dwarven. Oh, it chopped his head. Chopped it in half. And that's the last of the archers, and they are breaking. And we'll just go ahead and fast forward to the end of the results. So here we go. Sultan Thorn getting 1,703 kills. And Rune, which is Eva or Ivar, getting 1,800 kills. Extremely close when looking at kills. The armies were very similar in size. Again, I think Rune could have won this one very easily, but he just didn't have any reserves. And, you know, it was so close at the end. It was a great battle, great replay. This was sent in by Sultan Thorn, so thank you so much for the battle replay. It was really fun to watch. 230 from his Guards of Khazad-dûm, which is probably the highest amount of kills. His catapults, let's see, what did his catapult get? 151, which is pretty good for the catapult. And 109 from the Iron Guard. Iron Guard were kind of like the meat shield. Not really. I mean, they still got a ton of kills here, but they were like the first ones to go in. All right, guys, so that's going to wrap up today's battle. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, share, and if you haven't, be sure to subscribe. And I will see you in the next glorious battle.